My employer is the Anglican Diocese of Gippsland, which is a not-for-profit organisation. The Diocesan Council has decided to relocate the business centre to alternate premises without fully understanding the financial implications of their decision. My project is to consider these two mutually exclusive options and make a recommendation to the diocese about which is the best way to go. Scenario A is to remain in the existing premises which were purpose-built. To do this, they would need to spend some capital to reinvigorate the premises and meet ongoing maintenance costs. They would also need to spend significant funds on the new premises, an old house, to make it more attractive to a commercial tenant. Scenario B is to do as the Diocesan Council have directed and move the business centre into the refurbished house and leave the existing premises as they are and vacant for an indefinite period. The house has been vacant for 5 years now. Scenario B and Scenario A are mutually exclusive because the choice of one is to result in rejection of the other. The business manager is wanting me to explore the refurbishment costs as they are likely to be, and to learn from that what the financial implications will be over the next 5 to 10 years. These time periods fit with their budget projections and the likelihood of the diocese exhausting its financial reserves at the current rate of spending. The costs of the refurbishment will come from investments, not external finance, and this will reduce income. I therefore need to consider the value of the diocese's real and financial assets, their current and future cash flow and their timings, their historical data in terms of trends, and their aversion to risk. I know that their investments are spread between real property, term deposits and shares to enable them to meet short and long-term cash flow needs. I also know that there is an opportunity cost associated with the proceeding of either scenario. A large capital outlay for these purposes reduces the amount available for other ministry activities. I plan to look at the cash flow of both scenario A, which is to stay where they are, and scenario B, relocate to the new premises, and from that determine the net present value of each, which will then allow me to encourage the diocese to accept the scenario where the net present value is greater than zero. I also plan to do a cost-benefit analysis for both scenarios, a cost-effectiveness analysis, because it is difficult to assign a monetary value to outcomes in improving ministry opportunities across the diocese, and a cost minimisation analysis with the object of encouraging the diocese to choose the least costly course of action, which in this situation could be helpful if the benefits of scenarios A and B are equivalent.